guys, Immortal is here. Welcome back to a new video. As you know, yesterday I have uploaded a video on Grand Theft Auto San Andreas Vehicle Pack for low-end PC. So in that mod, I used in graphics mode, right? And many of my viewers had a curiosity to know what is the graphics mode that I used on that video. You know, so most of the people requested in comments, hey bro, can you please tell me what is the graphics mode? So I thought, wanted to make a video on it and let's gain some views, right? So in today's video, I'm gonna give you the best realistic graphics mode for your San Andreas, right? And let me answer you the most popular question. Will it work on low-end PC? Yes, of course, man, it will work on a low-end PC. This mod is designed for all categorized PC, you know. If you have a low-end PC, medium-end PC, high-end PC or ultra-high-end PC. Man, seriously, this mod is designed for all categorized PC, you know? You can actually run this graphics mod on any PC. Well, do you want to know how to install and how to use this graphics mod? Please make sure to watch this video till end. So yeah, should we start? Yeah, of course we do, you know? So without wasting any more time, let's get started to the video, guys. But before we get started, you know what I want. I want you to leave a like on this video if you can. And share this video to as much you can, and if you're new, then what are you doing? Please make sure to subscribe to our channel. So yeah, without any further ado, let's dive into the video, guys. Well, my friends, so as you can see, we are in our desktop screen, and first thing you need to get these two files. Make sure to check description for more information. First one is your optional 2.0 folder. Without this mod, you cannot run your main mod. And second one is the, of course, the main mod. Okay. So the second thing you need to do is make sure to extract a file into your desktop or any specific folder you want to extract. I will strictly recommend you to extract on your desktop because it's too easy to find out whether your folder has been extracted, you know, and you don't have to open your Windows. Okay, so once your optional 2.0 folder has been extracted, then simply just open your game directory, right? Now, once your game directory has been opened, then simply just open your optional 2.0 folder and then search for your SLEEWAS Loader Plus mod loader and then simply only copy these files, right? But make sure you copy only these selected files. Do not copy rest of them and make sure to replace all of this file into your game directory. Okay, once you did, then go back and then find your graphics fix, right? Now, from here also, only copy these selected files, not rest of them. Okay, so once you did, then from here what you need to do is open your RZL printer. Now, most of the people ask, what type of cheat menu you use in your video? So, actually, I use RZL Trainer. Everything is present in readme file if you don't have any knowledge how to open this. I'll show you in the gameplay also. Okay, now go back and then from here what you need to do is you have to open your widescreen fix. Open your script folders and then from here also only copy this ASI, NI, NI files, right? And then hit on replace if it asks. So, we have pretty much done with our optional 2.0 folder. Now you can close both of this window and then extract your main mod. Okay, so once your game directory has been opened, then open your SDirectX 2.0 single player. And I forgot to tell you, this is the CloudWork version of SDirectX 2.0. Okay, now from here, you have to choose your version, right? Now if you have a very low-end PC, then choose very low-end PC plus CloudWorks, and this very low-end PC doesn't contain CloudWorks, right? So this A version contains the CloudWorks and without A version doesn't contain CloudWorks, right? So I'm gonna show you the CloudWorks version. So, and CloudWorks version looks very awesome, right? Now from here, just simply drag and drop all of these files into your game directory and then hit on the place if it has. Okay, so we have successfully installed our mod into our game directory. And then just simply run your inb.txt, right? Now many of you will ask from where we can get inb.txt. Okay, so you have extracted my optional 2.0 folder, right? Just open that and then open your optional 2.0 folder. Unfortunately, I'm really sorry, I forgot to show you how to install the inb.txt. So simply just open your inb.txt folder and then just drag and drop into your game, right? And then simply run your env.txt and then your game will 100% start. No matter what it brings, you will listen. Alright guys, so as you can see, we are in your game and our game looks too awesome, isn't it? Now, if you want to config DirectX 2.0 with yourself, then all you need to do is hit Shift plus Enter together and then slider window will be opened and then from here you can customize it, you know. Now, let me show you the magic. If you press U, then this is really awesome, right? Now, if you want to access the trainer, then press F2 from your keyboard and then you can actually access your trainer. You can enable your guard mode. Now, no matter from which distance you fall or somebody tries to kill you, you will not die. Okay, one more thing, so open your vehicle option and then you can enable these three options, right? These are the guard mode of vehicle, right? And one more thing I just want to show to you. Now, if you want to change your car color, then go to your vehicle option and then go to your modify and then you can go to your color correction and then you can change whichever color you want to access, you know. And some of those special vehicles carries its own paint jobs, so something like this, right? So you can enjoy this too. So yeah, that's pretty much for today. That's the short video, right? So thank you so much for watching till end. I hope you all enjoyed this video. And if you're still watching, then you are my real support, right? So you have to like on this video, and if you already did, then thank you so much, man. I love you, right? So yeah, as always, I'll see you into the next one. Till then, goodbye.